In the metals quadrant today, taking a look at the December contract, which is on a two-day streak lower. On the downside today, we were down 1.75%. Four spot 3230 was the low. We finished the day down over 1%. It's now the second consecutive day where copper has been down over 1%. On the high today, we were up just short of 1% at four spot 4425. If copper finished lower this week, which currently we're down about 2.25% on the week, it would be the fourth week in the last five of lower copper prices. The month of November so far, down about 53 basis points, so a little bit more than a half of 1% for copper. Stocks are still declining, 20th week in a row. Last week, global copper stock piles declined by 9%. As I mentioned, that's the 20th week in a row of this, but many analysts, including some at Goldman Sachs, think that we may be nearing the bottom of this particular decline in stocks. Not long term, but in the very short term. In the very long term, green energy plan, the infrastructure deal was just passed and just signed into law. That is law. That's not something that another administration could just come in and turn around 2 years from now, 3 years from now. It is a law, and it would take a lot to sort of reverse that. So copper is going to be in demand, but in the short term, we could end up with more usable copper because Chinese blackouts, according to reports, we don't know for sure, but according to reports, the energy blackouts have slowed, potentially stopped. So the smelting operations are up and running again. China is not only the biggest consumer of raw copper, but they're the biggest smelter in the world of copper that can then be put into use in projects. Some of that in China, which a lot of that has slowed down, but other parts of the Pacific Rim also depend on China for their copper. So you could see a replenishment of these stockpiles over the next few weeks. Right now, copper not quite in a downtrend, but two consecutive days down, potentially for the last 5 weeks lower.